Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I guess I need to make two different videos. I've got to redo this. I already made a video, long video. Listen, someone had sent me a link of a video I made 2 days before Joshua died, when I just had found out he was sick, but I didn't know how severe. And I had this dream about being at the beach, and it was like time for the rapture, time for the tribulation, and all that. And I'll put the link below this. I want you to look at that. Watch the whole thing. There's lots of good things in that video. The point is that today, after I watched the video and I favorited it and liked it so it would go out so people would watch it because it's relevant for right now, the Lord just spoke to me out of the blue and said, the first horse in your vision is President Obama. Now, the second horse, I'm not going to tell you the details of the dream. I asked you to go see it, but the first horse in my dream tries to destroy the United States but is not able to, but the second horse does. So does that mean that the second horse is the next president? Does that mean you're going to have to wait 3 years before that person is elected? Maybe. It's also possible that President Obama's presidency could end early. We don't know that. We don't know what tomorrow holds. God only knows. And, you know, I don't want to discuss anything on that topic because, you know, it's, well, it's, you know, you have to watch what you say when you're talking about the president. One more lady told me, who doesn't make videos, she said, well, don't we speak by faith? No, it's not about speaking by faith. It's not speaking by faith to slander someone or, you know, make some, you know, say that I've seen people making videos, tons of people making videos, oh, Obama's the Antichrist. That's actually slander. And then not only because he's a president of the United States, but any person you start saying that, it's a slanderous comment. And if you're wrong, I mean, you know, it's very, you know, we'll see. We'll find out. You start calling people the Antichrist. I mean, that's a pretty big accusation against a person. It's probably the biggest insult, maybe, you know, that you can make against someone. It's slanderous. And then when you start talking about, I've seen people making videos that something was going to happen to President Obama, you know, that is also illegal. If it can be perceived that you are saying, like, you're involved or you're happy about it or whatever, you know, so these are facts. And it's not a matter of being afraid to say the Lord's will. The problem is that people are spouting, and it's not from the Lord. They're just, you know, just actually it's their own personal hates and dislikes. Like I said, I 100% disagree with President Obama's policies. I don't think there's a single policy of his that I like that I can think of. Maybe there is. And was he born in the United States? Maybe not. All those things aside. He is just another puppet on a string of all the presidents we had. And obviously the last president we had who tried to do the right thing was President Kennedy. Even though I'm not a liberal, I'm not a Democrat. President Kennedy tried to get us out of Vietnam. He printed his own fiat money. If you want to know why they really killed Kennedy and Lincoln, if you want to know the truth, because see, people don't know the real history, it's because President Lincoln also printed what they call greenbacks. He printed his own money, fiat money, and refused to pay interest to the Federal Reserve for it. They had a central bank for a while. They got rid of the central bank. They had a central bank. They got rid of it. People think that, who know anything about it, that they owe the Federal Reserve started in 1913. And income tax did too. That's true. But that we had some central banks in the past, and they were done away with. So, as a matter of fact, President Andrew Jackson, they tried to kill him 3 times. Because he refused, you know, he did away with the central bank. And the American government even gave people back a refund. That's the one and only time in history all the people in America got a rebate. Who paid taxes got a rebate under President Andrew Jackson when he did away with the central bank. Okay. And, you know, they came out with personal income tax. Just to tell you this, I don't know why I'm talking about this because I'm talking about the president. They came out with personal income tax and the Federal Reserve about the same time. And they, you know, they voted in the Federal Reserve at like midnight or whatever on Christmas Eve or whatever it was. Now, the reason why they did that was because, think about this, the American taxpayers pay for the cotton, the cloth they use to make money out of. It's actually made of cloth, not paper. They print the money on there, okay, and then they give it to the Federal Reserve. The Federal Reserve takes it from the Treasury, and then they loan it back to us at interest, our own money, which is created out of nothing. It's not backed by gold, silver, or anything. But we pay interest to the Federal Reserve. That's our national debt. It's interest on the money that they print. Okay? And, you know, they sell these bonds, these treasury bonds and all that stuff. So people pay an income tax to pay to their masters, and their masters is the Federal Reserve. And the Federal Reserve is secret. Nobody knows who the board members are. Only know who the chairman is, who's appointed by the president every 10 years. They don't know where the money goes, what they do, or anything. That's why this Ron Paul, he's been trying to get the Federal Reserve just audited to find out what they're doing with the money. For years and years and years, they won't even do that. It's the biggest scam ever perpetuated. And if you want to know who the Antichrist and all that is, follow the money. President Obama is just another puppet on the string. President Bush, all of them have done the will of the New World Order, and the New World Order is ultimately controlled by Satan. And that's where your Antichrist is going to come from. You want to know who the Antichrist is, where he's coming from? Follow the money. Follow the money. But anyway, the second one, whether he be the or she, be the next president of the United States, or some other world leader, I assume maybe it will be the next president. Their term could begin anytime, but it could be as late as, what would that be, January 2017, when the new president is sworn in. I have no idea. But go watch that video, you'll see what I'm talking about. God bless you guys.